Greetings everyone, in this video I am going to show you how to record your commands or actions as a script in Photoshop and execute that script as an automated batch on a folder of images. For demonstration, I am going to add a white background color to images with transparent backgrounds. I picked this as an example because since Stable Diffusion is not able to process transparent pixels, we have to fill transparent pixels with white color or any other color. Furthermore, I will show how to select all fully transparent pixels in an image and replace them with any color you choose. So let's start with opening our first image to record our script. You see the background is transparent. So first, we need to open the actions folder to start recording our actions. To do that, go to the window folder in the top menu, and in here go to actions button and click it. So you will open at the actions panel like this. First of all, we need to define a new action. To do that, go to the plus button on the actions menu and it will open this new action window. Let's give it a name, white background color. It will be saved in the default actions folder, and you can assign a function key and you can assign a name. I will assign as gray, for example, and click record. So now the recording is started. You can see that the red button in here is highlighted like this. So to add a white background, we are going to add a new layer. To do that, go to the right button and in here you will see plus icon. Just click it. It will compose a new layer, as you can see right now in here. So I will fill that transparent layer with white color. To do that, first I am clicking this eye icon. It is hiding the layer 1. I am going to left menu in here and I am picking the paint bucket tool. Right click it, you will see paint bucket tool. It is under the magic eraser tool. You could be also have selected this gradient tool or 3D material drop tool, so don't get confused if they are selected. Okay, so this is selected as a paint bucket tool and it will use the color displayed in here. I am using the white color and I am left clicking, so entire layer is filled with white background. Then I am enabling the layer 1 once again. I am moving it to up and now it is visible like this. Now we will merge them down with merge down. Okay, we are ready. If you want to save this image, overwrite it, then you should also go to the file and save it. However, if you don't want them and you want these actions to be executed and save it on a different folder, so you will both keep the source images and you will also have new images, then you shouldn't save it. You should just stop recording in here. Okay, I will stop the recording. Now our action is ready. Time to do batch execution. To do that, I will go to the left top menu in here, click file, and you will see automate in here, and just click the batch. So it will open the batch operations window for you. In here you will see the set as default actions. This is the action group. We saved our action and in here we will see the white background color. So we are going to first pick our source folder, click the choose and choose the folder that you want to execute on. I am selecting example folder, which where my monster artworks are located. And you can you should pick override action open command, because we didn't include we didn't include open command. Actually you shouldn't pick it unless you explicitly define it open command in your script. So we are not clicking it. You can click include all subfolders, suppress file, open option dialogs, and suppress color profile warnings. I am going to, by default it will be selected as stop for errors, but I don't want it to stop for errors, so I am clicking log errors to a file. pick a folder to save your errors. So to do that, click Save As button in here. Select the folder where you want to save. I will save them inside Downloads folder and give it a name, Error Logs. Just click Save and it will be also displayed here. Okay, now since we are going to save our images in a new different folder, I am picking the destination folder. You can also click Save and Close in here, as you can see. So it will just execute action script on the source images and then close them. So I am picking folder here. So let's pick a folder. Let's compose a new folder. Processed images. Okay. And then select folder. Okay. Override action save as command. This is what we are going to do. It will save as default like this. Actually, let's pick the, let's read the description. Override action save as command. Okay, when this option is on, files will be saved to the destination folder only by save as steps in action. So you should not pick this because we didn't explicitly save it. Okay, now we are ready. Let's just click OK. So the files will be opened, our script will be executed, then they will be closed and they will be saved inside our processed folder. Let's open it to see. Okay, the processing has finished. We got one error, which is this one. It says that could not complete the command because the selected area is empty. So if you encounter an error, you can check that specific file. So let's see, let's compare our processed images and example folder. So I am going to open an example image. These monsters are from my game, which is Monster MMORPG. Okay, let's just close this window first and then let's open our image. Okay, you see it currently has a white background like this, and let's also open its original version, which is here. I will open as a new tab. Okay, so this was the original image and this is the white background edit image. It is looking great, as you can see. It is as expected. Now I will show you the another thing, how to select all of the transparent pixels in this image and fill them with any color you want, but we will select the fully transparent images. For example, you see there is a semi-transparent part in here. It is as a shadow. So I am not also going to select this area, and I will select everywhere where it is fully transparent. To do that, click the control button, left control on your keyboard. Now click the layer image, the thumbnail, as you can see, right bottom in here. So it has selected all of the area that contains some pixels. Then go to the top menu, and in here you will see select under the select option, inverse. Okay, click inverse. So now transparent pixels are selected mostly. Then go to the quick mask mode, which is in the left menu. You will see edit in quick mask mode, which is Q letter on keyboard. Okay, then we are entered the quick mask mode. Then in here go to the image and adjustments, in here, and in here go to the threshold button, adjustments, image adjustments, threshold. So we are going to set the threshold level to 255. So you see when we set it to 255, it is selecting all of the pixels that is not fully transparent in the quick mask mode. Click OK, then exit from the quick mask mode. So now all of the pixels which are not fully transparent are deselected. So all of the fully transparent pixels are currently selected. Then we go to the edit menu in the top menu. And actually before doing that, we are selecting layer like this. Then we are going to the edit mode and we are going to go to fill. And in here we are going to fill with a color. It is currently selected as white. Click OK, click OK. And now all of the fully transparent pixels are filled with white color. So you see, if there is even a slight pixel, then no white color is filled, and if it is fully transparent, then the white color is filled, as you can see. So this will produce a different image than adding a white background layer to the image. It is up to you, whichever you want to do. So when you click save, it will be saved, and you see these two images are now currently different. Okay, if we save it this as an action, it would be also saved like the previous action, and you could also do batch execution like this on all of the images. So the script is working, everything working same principle for every action. You can do whatever you want with actions, save them and execute them on images as a batch. It is totally up to you. Thank you very much for watching. If you have enjoyed, please click like, subscribe and leave a comment. You can also join our Discord channel from about page of our channel. Go to about page and in here you will see official Discord channel. We also have a Patreon page. If you support us on Patreon, we would appreciate very much. Hopefully more quality videos will come soon. So far we have 6 patrons and I thank you very much to them. They are giving me strength to continue. Hopefully see you later in another video.